Well, it's been an incredible decade. London used to have a reputation as being a very difficult place to film, and now we're the third busiest production centre in the world. So Film London have played a huge role in that, and the current mayor has championed it, the previous mayor obviously championed it. So it's been a really successful project, successful organisation, and we're really pleased to be celebrating it today.
I mean, can you just put into scale for us the economic and social impact that London's use as a film production hub has?
The film industry generates millions for the economy every year, but also is a fantastic driver for tourism. London is now the most visited city in the world, and film, seeing London, seeing its sights on the cinema screens, on television now, is really important for raising the profile of the city. And I think that all those benefits accrue not just to London, but to the whole country. If you think about Harry Potter, it wasn't just filmed in London, it was filmed in Liverpool, in Scotland, in Oxford. That's a massive boon for the whole country, really.
Like you say, there's some fantastic productions here in the UK. Are there any that you could point to and say you think really represent the very best that London has to offer?
So hard to pick. I suppose the obvious thing to pick from recent memory is Gravity, just because the number of British people who worked on that film, and the fact that the director calls himself a Londoner, even though he came from somewhere else, I think that epitomises so much of what makes London great. It's a great magnet for talent from around the world. So if I had to pick one from recent history, it would be that, but there are many, many other films that I think have been a brilliant example of London.
The capital's really opened up to film production in the last 10 years. What changes, what kind of changes have made that possible?
I think what Film London do is a very practical help for film crews from around the world. So it used to be the case that you'd find it difficult to close a road or get filming permission. Film London now make that a very seamless process. So we've certainly helped them. We've closed down a few major roads in central London to help the odd blockbuster film. And I think we work very closely together. Film London have brilliant relationships around the capital, and that I think gives a lot of confidence and reassurance. And I know that the film crew for 24 the other day were saying how amazing London was, and that even when it was raining, the film crews were just out there doing their job, and that was for them a really important factor in why they were here.
Of course, I mean, today's about celebrating retrospectively the past 10 years, but it's also about looking to the future. What are you personally most excited about in terms of the future of film in London?
That Film London is no longer just about film, it's also about high-end television, animation. It's doing a lot of work on supporting the games industry in London. We know that's a very important financial boost for the country, and we want London to be a big part of that. So Film London are really thinking outside the box. They're using their imagination about how they can bring all the good work they've done so far to other sectors, and the mayor has been really supportive of that work.